68. And here we are on the 4th of July at Cordova High School, about to take in one of the largest firework displays in California. Maybe the whole United States. Anyway, hope you enjoy the show. And now, let's go direct to Nashville and look in on what Steve Lindelof is doing in his garden.
What are you doing?
Indy Hindy, come in,
what
Indy. Come in, Indy Hindy. Indy Hindy.
Who is this gentleman watering his plants?
Oh, hey, Mike.
Oh, it's Steve Lindelof.
Yeah.
Hey, what's going
nice
on, man?
See ya. It's
what's going on? Is this your backyard?
This is my backyard, my little balcony.
Wow, look at that, man. It's green.
I live in the woods, man.
Everywhere you turn, it's just green.
Yeah, I got a little bird feeder here. And I got some really, I know my birds, I look them up and identify them.
What kind of birds come around? Hummingbirds?
I don't have a hummingbird feeder anymore because it attracts ants and stuff. But,
yeah.
You know, of course we get cardinals all year round, and I get these thrashers and woodpeckers.
I can hear them.
Yeah, a lot of different kind of birds. I really enjoy them. I enjoy them a lot.
Cool. So what have you been up to lately?
Well, I keep on making music with Derry. You know, we got our Patreon for the choir.
Yeah.
So we do a song a month, Derry and Dan. And I recently did a project called The Ascendance with Phil Madeira and Matt Slocum and Jimmy Opal, A-Bag, and Ben.
Ben who? No. Are you having a moment right now?
Yeah, just like...
All right, let's all just pray for Steve right now.
I mean... You know, that's what happens. Does this happen to you?
Oh, gosh, you have no idea.
You know, people that your best friends? That,
yeah, well, you know what?
Pearson? Ben Pearson?
Yeah, Ben Pearson. Now, what is his
forgot.
What is his claim to fame?
Well, he's known for photography, and also he did all the stuff with Steve Taylor. He's the director of photography for Steve Taylor, but he also is a really good guitar player.
Yeah.
And did some songwriting, and so it was just a bunch of friends, and we made a record. A bunch of guys are singing that are not the lead singer, like me, and like Matt Slocum, who's never, he's got Lee Nash in his band, so why would he sing, but he has a really good voice. So we did that record, and other than that, I hike in the woods every day with my friend Phil Madeira, and I'm enjoying it. I'm just enjoying life here, and every now and then I get to do something special, like write a song with Mike Rowe. Which we did today. We've got a song called The Soul of You that I got to write some lyrics and melody to a 77's track. I understand you guys are doing a record finally. I don't know if I'll believe it until, you know, but I'm excited about that possibility. And so, yeah, I get to do, I just keep keeping on making music, and it's a pretty lucky deal.
Well, thank you for speaking with us. Is there anything you want to say to our Coronasphere fan base, which includes choir fans for certain?
Well, I'm really impressed that you guys have kept going this long. That's the moment. I'm stunned, actually, and surprised, you know, given that, I don't know, Mike, I wouldn't have thought of, you surpassed my expectation to continue that week after week after week after week. How many is it now?
Well, we're doing reruns now, but okay. This will be the 167th presentation.
Yeah, that's great. It's pretty impressive.
Well, so, you know, it's a testament to our fans. It really is more about them and the fact that they've kept the dream alive for all of us.
That's good. We got to keep it going, don't we?
We do.
We've got to keep it going. What else are we going to do? We've rowed out on the lake so far that we cannot see the shore. There's no retreating. There's nothing. We just have to keep rowing, right?
That's right. Just keep rowing.
Keep rowing. Yeah?
Yeah.
Keep Mike rowing.
That's ridiculous. All right.
All right.
Well, thanks for talking to us.
Thanks for hanging out with me on my balcony in Nashville.
You bet. We'll see you soon.
The greats lost track of all time. The late greats turpentine. You can't hear it on the radio. You can't hear it anywhere you go. The best band will never get signed. Case set start, butcher's blind. Are so good you won't ever know. They never even played a show. You can't hear them on the radio.
It's 117.
117, babe. It's like the numbers just keep adding up, and I just get more tired with the higher the numbers go.
How did we get here?
I don't know. Thankfully, 1 week, one show at a time, one number at a time. And I think it calls for a celebration. What you got there? Can I moocha kombucha
from slambucha.
You? Slambucha clink. Lift.
Here's to everyone.
Separate my lips.
Oh, man, when I'm drinking that stuff, that brings me back to Sun Records.
Yeah.
I think about all them cats drinking that nasty stuff.
We visited there once, didn't we?
Yes.
We went when we were on tour.
Oh, yeah, man.
We went to Graceland.
We went to Sun. We went in there. We did the whole thing, man.
Yeah.
So let's dedicate this to that our favorite 17-year-old, wherever she may be, since we're 117. We're going to do... I got the lumps in my throat when a car coming down the aisle. I got the wiggles in my knees when you looked at me and sweetly smiled. There she is again, standing over by the wrecking machine. Looking like a model on the cover of a magazine. She's too cute to be a minute over 17. Let's bring it down now. Meanwhile, I was thinking, she's in the mood. No need to break it. I got a chance. I ought to take it. If she can dance, we can make it. Come on, Queenie. Let's shake it. Go, 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 little Queen Anne. Whoa, go, 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 little Queen Anne. Go, 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 little Queen Anne. Well, tell me who's the queen standing over by the record machine. Looking like a model on the cover of a magazine. A minute over 17. Well, meanwhile, I was still thinking, if it's a slow song, we'll omit it. And if it's a rocker, son, that'll get it. And if it's good, she'll admit it. Come on, Queenie, let's get with it. Go!
Little Queenie.
We're too cute to be a minute over 117.
Well. Well, now.
Bruce and I have been on a Paul McCartney jag, fetish, whatever you want to call it. And you know, we opened the door to him on his 80th birthday on the show, and we just can't quite get past him. So I think he's going to be a permanent fixture here for a little while.
You go ahead and open it so I can remember it.
Okay, this is a very minimalistic song that Paul put together for his first solo album at home with Linda and the kids. Just a little, you know, little banging little number. And I'm almost convinced, maybe some of you pundits out there that keep track of our tunes and what we're doing might remember if we did this once before. I'm going to put money on that we did. But we're going to expand this out a little bit because Bruce is feeling a little slighted. He needs to be singing a little more. So I'm going to...
But you started, though.
I'll start it.
I can't remember it. Oh, okay. I got it now. Okay. I'll do it.
That would be something. That would be something. That would be something.
Falling rain.
we got way more out of it than he did.
Well, that was pretty interesting.
Interesting, yeah. An hour of conversation and improvisation.
I had it in my mind to begin with when we were talking about it, and then I got cold feet right at the beginning.
You did.
And then you started playing the melody, and I was all sure. That was really...
It all came back to you.
It was, yeah.
In a flash.
It was a really tentative entry on that. Well, now I know it because I'm thoroughly...
I'm just grateful that music memory seems to be one of the last things to go. And,
Oh, wow, that's not good.
Yeah, it's not. Not when you're forgetting things like that.
It must
that.
Mean must mean I'm
mean
getting
you're
nearer,
way
man.
Gone. But,
Hey, speaking about way gone, let's say hello to our brother, Mr. Christian Harrelson.
Christian Harrelson.
How's it going from way gone?
It's going.
Oh. Still going.
Still going. Takes a licking and keeps on ticking.
Good. Well.
Well, speaking of sticking with certain artists, you know, I still got the Cat Stevens in my blood from these last several weeks. I'm also trying to bring songs to you that you might not have heard.
Oh, that's good.
Because it seems like
it's always good.
Well, I know, because when you hear them, you go, "Whoa, what another great tune!" You know, yeah. I just keep digging them up, and it's like. Miles from nowhere. Guess I'll take my time. Oh yeah, to reach there. Up the mountain, I have to climb. Oh, yeah, to reach there. Lord, my body has been a good friend, yeah, but I won't need it when I reach the end. I guess I'll take my time. Oh, yeah. To reach there. I creep through the valley and I grope through the woods. 'Cause I know when I find it, my honey, it's gonna make me feel good. 'Cause I love everything, so don't it make you feel sad? 'Cause I drink to you, my baby, and I think to that. I think to that. From nowhere, not a soul inside. Oh yeah, but it's all right. I have my freedom. I can make my own rules. Oh yeah, the ones that I choose. Oh, in the end, yeah.
reach there.
Yeah.
Nice.
I definitely never heard that one. When was that one done?
Oh, same time as all those other ones, like 71, 70, something
what
like that.
What record was that?
That was from T for the Tillerman. That's probably one of the most chock full of great tunes, and it was very popular, sold really well. I think Wild World was on there, Peace Train, all those tunes.
Never had the record, but liked those songs.
I think that you would enjoy not only the songs, but the production and the whole. For that period, I mean, they sounded great. They had a lot of dynamics, recorded really well, and the arrangements, all the everything about it was really cool.
Well, we'll have to do a deep dive and listen for
absolutely.
That,
yeah.
For our upcoming sessions.
Absolutely. Yes, we are upcoming sessioning.
Yeah, we're going to go on a little
road trip.
Tell everybody we're doing a road trip.
We're going to go see our old buddy Vic.
Yeah, we're going to go up north and do some recording, and Chris is going with us, and we're going to film it. It's going to be awesome.
Great studio up there.
Yeah.
That's news to him. I don't know.
He knows.
I don't know, but...
I know. I just don't know exactly when.
He just
we'll
hasn't
find,
been...
We'll find him in these fields.
He just doesn't know how much money he's about to lose.
But...
tens of dollars.
We worked with Vic over 20 years ago on our Christmas album, so those of you who are a big fan of that will...
Crimbo.
Yeah, the Happy Crimbo album. He's the only guy I've ever seen who besides you, that I've told him this so I can say it. He was using that thing called Vegas Video. Remember that strange sort of thing? It was an audio program for video, but he was using the audio part of it to record our record. But it had a glitch, or there was some kind of weird setting. I don't know what was wrong, but every time he'd record something, it would move in time.
Oh, wow.
So he had to hand place every single vocal, every single guitar, every single drum hit. You know, I don't even know if we had a kit on that record very much. A lot of it was just sort of
the Christmas.
Kind of like what we're doing.
It's a little bit, but yeah.
But mostly it was very organic, done kind of like this. And I'm just watching him going, how do you do it? You know, but man, he lined everything. You know, he had that ear.
I think we did at least a couple things. We did the Run, Run, Rudolph had a drum kit.
Yeah, that was earlier. Yeah, that was me, you, and Mark recorded that, I think.
Okay, and then
Scott might have helped
us
a bit.
We also did like What Child Is This or something
like that.
Right.
And, you know, one of these Julys we'll record another Christmas record because that's when you have to do it. Every Christmas album is recorded in July. And it's the last thing you want to do is set up a tree and a bunch of presents in the sweltering heat and sing about, you know, Rudolph. But I think we'll do it one day. Well, okay, so Cat Stevens came along at a time. He was a British folk singer. And just to give you a little background, there's a lot of great British folk singers that came out of the 60s, and Cat Stevens was at the tail end of that. This guy, Donovan, who had a lot of hits in the 60s, had a big influence on the Beatles. He taught them the Travis picking style that we talked about last week.
Wow, that was Donovan.
And he was with them on that trip to India when they went to see the Maharishi and they were doing the meditation and everything. And
I never realized that.
He was with them. Well, there's a bunch of people that were on that trip, but you could only bring guitars. They couldn't bring drums and everything for them to play. So they sat around and wrote, and he said that he was sitting one day doing that Travis picking. It's a certain kind of thing. And, you know, John Lennon's watching him, you know. Eventually he comes up and says, so how do you do that, mate? He says, oh, that? And so he said, well, it took me quite a while to learn it, but I can show you. He says, John got it in a few days. And then Paul learned it. And that's where all those ones like, you know, Mother Nature's Son and Blackbird. And I mean, I'm sitting there going.
So they learn that and go, right, Blackbird.
Yeah, it's like Donovan walks in with just a simple little thing that he learned from someone else. Oh. He shows them, and they just went to town. And half the White Album, there's that picking style, you know, of Happiness is a Warm Gun, Julia, all those great tunes. And I'm thinking, man, they got an awful lot of miles out of just one little thing.
Nice.
So we're going to do a little two-song tribute to Donovan today. Here's...
Yellow is the color of my true love's hair in the morning when we rise. In the morning when we rise, that's the time, that's the time I love the best. Blue is the color of the sky.
When did that come out?
Oh gosh, mid-60s, like 64.
Wow. What a performance, man. Really nicely done, Mike.
Thank you. That's a, yeah, it's a really great little tune.
Gosh, I caught right at the end was the you know, the Lindsey Buckingham.
Well, it's interesting how all these things filter down to that next generation. I mean, Lindsey definitely was a student of folk music.
We need to do that song. Which one is that?
Well, which one now? Sing it.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. I gotta learn. You know, I've played it in a kind of a
yeah, that one's cool
bastardized way for a lot of years. I gotta sit down and really.
I think it's the same. It's literally the same.
It's very similar.
Same key.
Yeah, it's very similar.
It's like the instrumental versus the vocal version of Junk from last week.
Oh.
Okay, this was the one that broke Donovan.
In the chilly hours and minutes of uncertainty, I want to be in the warm hold of your love in mine. To feel you all around me, and to take your hand along the sand. I bet I may as well try and catch the wind. When sundown pales the sky, I wanna hide a while your smile, and everywhere I look, your eyes I'd find. For me to love you now, 'twould be the sweetest thing, 'twould make me sing. Ah, but I may as well try and catch the wind. Kill my fears, to help me to leave all my blues behind. Standing in your heart is where I want to be and long to be. But I may as well try.
What year was that?
64.
Have you ever heard this? I mean, it's been around.
Well, you know, it's funny because it feels
been in
like
movies. And...
It feels like, you know, Sonny and Cher grafted their song off this.
Oh, which one? I mean, like, I Got You, Babe.
Yeah, yeah. It's...
Well, I.
They say love will be
Wow. I would have never, ever. I got to hand it to Bruce, man.
I got you, babe.
Bruce is extremely astute at capturing a melody in his mind and then realizing.
See where you ripped it off from?
Yeah, well, that's a bit, you know.
Yeah, that's not.
I mean, I wouldn't put it that way in that case. What I would say is that the familiarity of I Got You, Babe probably.
Well, the. Hey, say hello. You know, I mean, it's like, man.
But let's face it, Dylan was singing. You know, people accuse Donovan of copying Dylan and so on and so forth, which really isn't a fair thing to do because there were many folk singers at that time that were singing in that tradition, and a lot of those folk melodies are copied and pasted across the ages. I mean, that's the folk tradition. So
times they are a changing.
They are. I mean, Dylan's the greatest. I consider him the greatest creative thief ever because if he ever copied, he always brought to the table so much more than what he took. You know, like Led Zeppelin, the same thing. I mean, they all, you know, Page and
It was
Plant.
An inspiration. He put it right there and then he really evolved it a bit.
It's like if you're going to steal...
He did it justice.
Yeah, if you're going to steal, bring something back, you know, to it so that it grows rather than just copying and that's it. Right. And, you know... Anyway, I don't want to get
so what's
far into
what
that.
Now what's this?
We have done this on the show before. We are entering the hymn show portion, which we've been neglecting.
This the is a hymn show,
hymn show portion.
Sounds like more work for me.
We need a clever hymn show portion thing now.
Well,
well. That's like on Jimmy Fallon. The Roots have a little vocal, you know, sort of thing for every little section of the show. Every little gag.
Oh, I don't watch that, so that is that funny?
Well, so you totally came up with that.
Oh, that's good.
On your own, and that's
great. I don't
watch
it at all.
That's great. See, Bruce is just naturally creative. It's like the ideas are out there. He's going to get them.
Well, one would think that I would have been on to the idea that that idea was taken from that. You know what I mean?
And he's just revealing the stealing. Revealing the stealing.
I swear I didn't even know. Okay.
Chris Christopherson, everybody. Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head that didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more. For dessert.
I
fumbled through my closet for my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. And I shaved my face and combed my hair and stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I'd smoked my brain the night before with cigarettes and songs that I've been picking. But I lit my first and watched a small kid cussing at a can that he was kicking. Then I crossed the empty street and caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I'd lost somehow, somewhere along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing the Lord that I was stoned, 'cause there's something in a Sunday that makes a body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound on the sleeping city sidewalks Sunday morning coming down. In the park I saw a daddy with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the song that they were singing. Then I headed back for home, and somewhere far away, a lonely bell was ringing. And it echoed the canyons like the disappearing dreams of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned, 'cause there's something in a Sunday that makes a body feel alone. There's nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound on the sleeping city sidewalks Sunday morning. Thank you.
great tune.
Yeah, man.
All right.
You know, times they are changing. I mean, you can do a hymn show and say the word stoned.
Speaking of change.
Oh, who's got loose change?
Who's got loose change? A chunk of change. That's right.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, folks, you know, we ain't those TV preachers and we ain't them politicians. All we are is a couple guys singing and a guy on a bullhorn at the controls, at the helm.
And a guy watching and filming.
One guy watching. Yes.
Couple guys singing and another guy watching.
So, I mean, basically, you know, when people ask me, so, you know, you'd play any gigs? I go, well, rarely. I said, but I'm busking. And they go, well, what's that? And I go, you know, I'm busking online. It's modern, man. This is a modern thing. We're not going down to the street corners.
I feel like busking loose. Hey, so, and you know, that was not even true because our guy who's watching is singing too. He's contributing, and he's kazooing.
So,
whenever possible.
Well, I was talking about the amount of people in the audience.
Oh.
Sorry, I shouldn't have lost my head. No, we love you.
What are
Lord
you
knows we
talking lo- about?
One guy watching out. Oh, God.
Keep the G rating. Keep the G rating.
Sometimes, you know, I crack myself up.
When I just said contributing to him, I was thinking of that. Remember last week when Mark was like, said, man, great contributions. Did you catch that?
Yeah.
He's all contribution. What was occurring to him, man, at the time?
All right. Well, look, so if you want to help move this thing along, PayPal.me/
And we need to move this thing along.
We need to get this thing going.
Yeah. We haven't even, we've been, how long is this show so far? And we haven't heard one bullhorn.
Well, it's not time yet.
Oh, really?
Unless you want to get into that.
I'm sorry.
PayPal.me/MICRO77S, like Sam. If you like Venmo, it's at MICRO77S. And if you want to write a big fatty check, 77S LTD on the check, then on the envelope, same thing, P.O. Box 1441, Citrus.
As in barking for your contributions.
Heights.
Like where we'd like the bank balance to be.
California, 95611.
Okay, now, citrus is in what? Barking?
Barking for your contributions. I mean, I'm running out of...
What's that?
Bark of the citrus tree.
Oh, my gosh.
You're so sophisticated, man.
I'm so sorry.
It's a whole nother level.
I'm trying to meet you on a lower level.
I think,
clearly, of the
all
tree.
All right, you guys... I'm going to let them go off on their own little trip. I'm going to call upon North... Where? What do you call it, Chris? It's that
tune
time!
Tune in, North Kakalaki!
Markalina! Hey, pal! What's up?
Phone's not working, so I'm going to record.
That's cool, man. You ready to play that bass?
Oh, yeah.
Then get them big bass, big man, bass man. He's a bass man, plays bass. we're gonna pitch you three tunes this week.
Oh, boy.
And I'm really happy about that.
You know, I almost heard you recalling Don Bound's article on Mark.
Oh, big bass. I was going to say it. He just said it, G-rating. I've been holding back a lot of things, ladies and gentlemen. A lot of really funny things, because I want your kids to be safe. And this is a safe show.
It's safe and sane.
Safe and sane. We just had a safe and sane holiday, man. We neglected to sort of honor it last week, so we're honoring it this week. You know, better late than never.
Better late.
You know, waving old glory for the sake of y'all. We hope you didn't blow any hands off, or your kids, you know, got home okay, and hope you saw some good fireworks. Yeah, that's a sore subject for me in this town. So I'm going to just skip that for now, and we're going to move on. We're going to move straight towards a Dylan classic, staying in the hymn show mode. Mark, we want you to play your best. Gosh, who played bass on this? I can't think of him now. But anyway, this was cut, I think, in Memphis. somewhere down there. It's swampy and...
milk.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you might like to eat a caviar, yeah. And you might like to eat some bread.
Too much.
You may be sleeping on the floor or sleeping in a king-size bed. You're gonna have to serve somebody. Yeah. Yeah, you're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
You might be the devil.
Dickie.
You may call me Dr. Love, or you may call me Dr. Hay. You can call me anything, but no matter what you say, you're still gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
Yes, you are. You're gonna have to serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
And it may be the devil.
Nice, boys. What nice. A nice little touch you got right there.
Well, good job, Mark.
Well, thank you.
All right, Mark. We are, well, here, hey, ladies
thanks,
and gentlemen.
Thanks for your service.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
I'll give you my
contribution. And so because Mark has been doing such a great job, we're going to honor him with a couple of tunes that we know he loves that he brought to the band 30 years ago or more. There was a weird transitional period that happened. We had our 80s version of the group, and when that thing splintered, we went through this murky sort of period where we didn't, you know, I think Tootle was out, and we, what did we do? We had me, Dave, I don't even know if Dave...
Jan was in, right?
Jan was still in, yeah. But we switched him to guitar.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And we put Mark, we brought Mark in, put him on bass, and I don't know if Dave was playing with us yet. I think it might have been a quartet. Maybe he was. I honestly don't remember.
But once you did, you because
well
you,
then
you
we were, did bring him in, and then
you
it was
were trying
five.
To just permanently graft the straw man into the band.
Well, yeah, we were trying to bring the straw man into the band. It didn't work exactly because it was a little bit strange. So there was a couple of years where we were doing a combination of like overseas things where we were, you know, like Jan moved to Nashville to manage Charlie Peacock. And so it got to the point where Jan wasn't able to rehearse with us. And we had him on guitar. We're out there doing, we would fly to Holland or someplace and play these big festivals unrehearsed except for the four of us. And it was a bit janky, but there was a period where there was a five-piece 77s. But prior to that, we were still doing our gigs here in California that we'd built up, like the Wild Blue Yonder and the DKs and some of these clubs that we'd built a big following in. And I remember you sat in on some of those at the time. I know you played the Wild Blue with us during that period. But we were doing some of these songs that Mark was bringing in that he used to play back in North Carolina when he was in college. And one of these we're going to do right now, I think Robert Gordon had recorded this tune. It was originally by, what, the Johnny Burnett rock and roll trio.
That would be correct.
Which, I inadvertently borrowed from when I wrote what's the one, Where It's At. In fact, inadvertently, another one of those steel things. In fact, when I was listening to this to relearn it after 30 years, I realized that this sounds exactly like Where It's At in a lot of ways.
I think you're inadvertently admitting it.
So anyway, we're going to do this one for you, Mark. I know you love it. Just try to see if you listen. Get ready for stop. A lonesome train on a lonesome train. I'm going away. Ain't coming back. I'm going somewhere far from my baby. On a lonesome train. On a lonesome track. A lonesome train. On a lonesome track. Got all of my trouble in a one big pack. My baby left me so sad and lonely. On a lonesome train. On a lonesome track. Hard to do that on an acoustic, you know, but
yeah, it's
but still, you know, we do it the Coronasphere way. Thanks, Mark. All right, you ready for one more, Mark? This is one of your personal favorites, so we have mentioned this group quite a bit on the show because this is one of Mark's favorite bands and certainly became one of mine in time. And I believe Chris Harrelson has a soft spot. And, Bruce, you have come to like them when we play you.
That video's crazy, man.
Yeah.
It's like they were like being a kind of a pop rock group.
Younger than their years.
Well, I always saw them as kind of, you know, a cool underground kind of thing. And then when I saw them, I'm like, oh, wow, that's interesting, you know.
Well, they were going for the pop market and they had a little hit. I mean, this song that we're about to do was a hit in the early 60s. It's called It's a Wild Weekend, and it was kind of one of those saxophone, you know, grunging, you know, and you see Annette and Frankie Avalon on the beach. They're all doing the twist, and it was kind of
So they kind of went there.
So what they did was they took it and they made it a snappy, something way cooler.
Well, that bass player I noticed on that video, he was playing a black Jerry Jones.
Well, that's where Mark got the.
But that was the pre-Jerry. That was just a Dan Electro.
Oh, that was a Dan Electro. Okay, that's very cool.
Yeah, it was black. I looked at it and I'm like, whoa, visions of Mark.
Yeah, and now Mark eventually did purchase the black Jerry Jones, which we have here. And some of you have seen me play it on the choir tours over the years. These Jerry Jones basses, I don't know why they don't make them anymore. It's just one of the best instruments that's ever been made. And Mark proves that every week. So you're going to prove it again tonight, Mark. Let's see now. I got to really get my thing up.
Shits that sail the seas.
And Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.